It's been a long time since I can say that a TV show has grabbed me within the first 4 minutes of the first episode and sucked me in. A new show on Netflix called Gedi Haji, or in English, Duty Shame, is just such a program. As I said, it's a Netflix show, it's 8 episodes long, and it's one of the best Japan-centric dramas that I've ever watched. A detective from Tokyo scours London for his missing brother, who has been involved with the Yakuza and is accused of murder. Yes, this is a story that involves the Yakuza, but this is not the usual yelly, shouty, screaming Yakuza that you often see portrayed in Western and Japanese movies and TV programs. No, this is much more closer to what the real thing is like. They're a lot more quiet and insidious, and I think the TV show is a whole lot better off for it. The show switches regularly between Japan and London, and there are a number of storylines happening all at once. And despite all of these multiple storylines going on all at once, there's police in London, police in Tokyo, Yakuza in Japan, gangs in London, despite all of these things going on and a family drama unfolding in the middle of all that, the TV show does a really good job of balancing all of those various storylines. You get a handle on who is who, and you can follow them and the various storylines and how they all interplay with each other very, very well. And I think that's a mark or a sign of a well put together show when you can follow along everything quite easily. It's one of those really wonderful things spinning out of control type TV shows like Breaking Bad or Ozark. And it's one of those shows that as characters make decisions and things go wrong, you find yourself cringing knowing just what a giant hole they're starting to put themselves into. And that's one of the main draws of this, is it's you're constantly thinking, how the heck is this character going to get out of this? And that was the thing that we just absolutely loved about it. The series does make some pretty weird artistic choices in places. There's one towards the end in particular, which I'm thinking of, and you'll probably guess what it is if you've seen the show. But because of how good the show has been put together, those odd artistic choices somehow work on some level. There was one point where Mrs. B and I looked at each other and we said, I don't know what the heck is going on. It's so weird, but I love it. It was one of those really, really odd moments that really helped draw everything together. But it was done in such an artistic, a weirdly artistic way that somehow it all paid off. It's probably going to mean nothing to you if you haven't seen the show yet. But if you have seen the show, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. Now, this might sound odd, but I really hope that they don't make any more of this show. I hope they leave it as a limited one-run series. And the reason for that is because I think they tied it all off really nicely. There were some things that were tied off, there were some things that were left open, and there were some things that were left ambiguous enough to make you want to keep talking about it and keep speculating and keep a discussion going. And I think it's perfect when a TV show does that. I reckon this is a little bit of a hidden gem on Netflix. I don't know how available it is worldwide. We, of course, watch this here in Australia. But if you can find Gedi Haji on your Netflix queue, or maybe in English, you can find it as Duty Shame. And if you like crime shows with a twist, then this is definitely worth a spot on your watch list.
We crossed a line.
We're not bad people. We just did bad things.